In this video, we will learn to add more pins to our Arduino board using this module. I will demonstrate it with an Arduino UNO and an ESP8266 board WEMOS. We also test the output by blinking LEDs and a relay, then test the input of this expander module by reading input from a button and an infrared sensor. And we also try to use more than one module to a single Arduino board, so we got 16 additional pins. This is the PCF8574T IC module. This module can give you 8 more pins for each module. This is actually the same IC that we used for the I2C LCD backpack. But this module is used as I/O expander. There are two types that are popular on the market, the blue one and the red one. They have the same function. We can change the I2C address. For red one, you can change the address by switching the little slide switch here. It has 8 I/O pins from P0 to P7. And then we have the I2C pins to connect to Arduino right here. And for the blue module, you can change the address by moving the jumper. And for other pins, I think it is the same as the red one. Let's connect this module to Arduino. As usual, the I2C pins to Arduino are SDI to pin A4 and SEL to pin A5. The power pins are VCC to 5V and ground to ground. For ESP8266 boards like NodeMCU, WEMOS or others, you can connect the SDA to D2 and SEL to D1. After the wiring is completed, now open the Arduino IDE. Let's find the I2C address by using I2C scanner sketch. You can download the sketch from the link in the description below. Upload the code and open the serial monitor. Now you should see your address here. For me, it is 27 hexadecimal. When I try to change the address, it is working. It is changing to 23, 21, 20. '24, '26, and so on. Let's just use 27 hexadecimal for now. Wait, before we continue the video, you can make me really happy by subscribing to this channel and tap the bell so you won't miss new video from me. After we got the address, let's start program the Arduino to control this module. You can download the library from the link in the description below. I use the library written by XRIF. After the download is completed, extract the library on your Arduino library folder. Restart the Arduino IDE, then open the example sketch called Blink on Pin 0. And you can also try the other examples as well. Paste the address we found earlier. It is on 27 hexadecimal. And now I will just test randomly the pin output. I will use P0, P3 and P5 by connecting 3 LEDs to them. I'll make these 3 LEDs blink sequentially. So I will turn on and off every LED by using the digital write command. This is the digital write command. We just need to write the object name followed by .digitalWrite. So the only differences with the original digital write on Arduino is the object name and pins. Then upload the code. And this is the wiring diagram with the LEDs. Now as we can see, the LED is blinking sequentially. This means our test for this module is successful. Now let's try connect two modules to a single Arduino board. But for this example, let's just use the WEMOS board, a small board that only has some pins. So maybe we will often use additional pins on a small board like this. So I connect the blue and red module to a WEMOS. Here's the wiring diagram. I use a breadboard to help connect multiple wiring on I2C pins. Let's upload the I2C scanner again and open the serial monitor. As you can see, now we have two addresses that read. The hexa 27 is definitely our first module, the red one. So the 20 hexadecimal should be the blue module. Now I'll connect a relay module to P1 of the blue module. So now we have two modules. I will name the first module as first and the second module as second. So it has 27 hexa value and the second is 20 as address. Then don't forget to set the pin mode. So I should change this name to first since the name is first. And then the second, I'll just use the pin mode to pin that we will use as an output. And then we begin the modules. So we should begin the first and the second module. Then we should edit the free name of the module. So it should be first. And then we also blink the second module on pin 7. It will blink the relay that we connect to the pin 7. When it's done, let's upload the code and see the result. We have tested the modules as output. Let's test the input. So I will connect a button to pin 0 of the module and an infrared sensor to P1. So here's the wiring diagram. In the program, I use the pin as input pull-up. And then, as you can guess, I use a digital read on the first object. Then, if the button pin is low, it will print button pressed on serial monitor. But if not, it will print nothing. And if the infrared pin is low, it will print infrared detected. Upload the program and this is the result. Now, as you can see, whenever I press the button, it will print button pressed on serial monitor. And when there is object in front of the infrared sensor, it will print infrared detected. I think this is the end of the video. Consider like and subscribe if you think this video is useful. If not, you can still subscribe because it really makes me happy. Thank you.